Welcome to the class of social science for civics, class 6, chapter number 2. The name of the chapter is Diversity and Discrimination. I repeat, Diversity and Discrimination, part 1. In the contents of part 1, we are going to discuss about what is discrimination. I repeat, discrimination. In this, we will study about its characteristics, types of discrimination, and we will also discuss about prejudice. Okay, prejudice, in this we are going to discuss about its causes, effects, components, and what is the difference between bias and prejudice. Now, you know what, in a simple English we use discriminate means to distinguish. To distinguish means to getting separate from one. Many things are there and we need to discriminate. For example, take your fingers. Okay. Now in this finger, this is the smallest finger. Okay. Now this finger can be discriminated. Why? So because these three fingers are good in height. Okay. They are good in length. But this finger is smaller one. So this can be discriminated, this can be distinguished very easily. So that is discriminate means to distinguish, okay? Single out or make a distinction. Now in everyday life, when faced more than one option, we discriminate in arriving almost every decision we make. Yes. Now you know what? We used to select, there are so many things in front of you. For example, your mama has made so many things in front of you. And all other things, mostly other things that you like to eat, okay, pizza, burger, pasta, like this. So many varieties she has made for you. And among that variety, she had made a dish, a mixed vegetable that you don't like to eat. So that is said to be discriminated, okay. You are going to get it apart. Mama, this is the thing that I really don't like, that all other things I like, okay. What's this called? That vegetable is to be discriminated over there. You are making it distinguished from all other things, okay. So in plain English, discriminate means over here to distinguish one thing from other groups. Now, but you know what, according to the civil laws, okay, according to the laws of our India, discrimination is a very unlawful activity, okay. We cannot do discrimination among the group of peoples, among the, inside the society. That is the very different thing, personal thing that you had done, the vegetables or the dishes were there, and among them, you had discriminated one mixed vegetable dish, okay. But here discrimination over here, it's an unfair and unequal treatment, okay, for especially for any individual or any group. Now for take an example, in your class there are several students here, there are several classmates you are having. Now among them there is one student who is not physically good, who is very weak, who is very sick also, okay. That what you used to do, you used to discriminate that student, that particular student is not good in a class. He is not good in studies, or he is not good in health. He is always to be feel very sick. Okay, what is this called? This is called discrimination. Okay, and this is actually a very unlawful thing. It means it is a sort of a crime that you are doing inside the society. Now, according to all these things, discrimination can be have certain characteristics. Okay, can be mentioned in certain characteristics, which include age, disability, ethnicity, gender, marital status, okay. Marital status over here means that you're married or unmarried, okay. National origin, race, religion. Now I repeat once again, age, disability, ethnicity, gender, marital status, national origin, race, religion, age. Now age means, you see, many times you have seen in the society that the older people, okay, above the age of 50s or 60s, they are being discriminated, okay. The children don't behave properly with their parents, okay, when we are the senior citizens at the age, after the age of 60. Okay, disability means over here where you are having any physical problem, you are not able to walk properly, you are not able to listen or see, they are the people discriminated from the society. Ethnicity over here means your moral values, okay, according to your moral values, your principles you should follow, and you are not following those things and you are making the discrimination inside the society, you are not behaving properly. Gender, male and female one. Marital status, you are married or unmarried. Over there also discrimination is being done. Now national origin, oh my god, have you seen her in the Indian national movement? Is that we told you all in SST also that Americans, in Britishers, they used to discriminate the Indians, okay? In South Africa also, in America, the black and the white people, that is said to be the discrimination of the national origin, okay? They are the South Africans, they are the black people. So over there also, they used to discriminate. Race, the same thing. Religion comes over here. Race is actually coming for the caste and creed, okay? You are from the scheduled caste, scheduled tribes, that is also discriminated. Religion, you are a Hindu, oh my god, I am a Hindu, you are a Muslim, you are a Muslim, so you are discriminated from our society. That is said to be the religion. Now, usually, come let's discuss about the types of discrimination. There are five types of discrimination. How many types of discrimination? Five types of discrimination. Number one, sex or gender discrimination. Number two, disability discrimination. Number three, age discrimination. Number four, racial or ethnic discrimination. Number five, religious discrimination. I repeat once again and you are going to repeat with me, okay? Number one, first of all, let's discuss, there are how many types of discrimination? There are five types of discrimination. How many types? Five types. Number one, sex or gender discrimination. Number one, sex or gender discrimination. Number two, disability discrimination. Number two, disability discrimination. Number three, age discrimination. Number three is age discrimination. Number four, racial or ethnic discrimination. Number four is racial or ethnic discrimination. Number five, religious discrimination. Number five, religious discrimination. Okay, so how many types of discrimination we learn today? There are five types of discrimination. Now, sex and gender discrimination that I have told you regarding on your male or your female. There are two groups only in the gender. You all know the masculine and the feminine. Okay, now disability discrimination, where you are individual separate from each other as per your physical appearance. Age discrimination, your age factor as if you are very older one or you are a small child. Racial or ethnic discrimination, over here depends on your behavior, okay? Religious discrimination based on the religion. Now, first of all, let's continue with the types of discrimination. Number first, we will discuss about racism. What does it mean? As again I repeat, racism. Now, one of the most common forms of discrimination is when the people are treated differently or unfairly because of their race. This is called racism. This is called racism. Okay? Now here, what does it mean? It means that where the person is not treated properly by other groups. Okay? It means their behavior is very rude and harsh. Now for example, I give you, there are the group of students sitting in one class, and over there among them one student is there who is very weak, who is very dull, who don't study, okay, and below average student, okay. Now over there, usually what the students used to do, students used to discriminate that person, okay. They don't used to help that person for improving their his or her study. They are not talking to that person also. This student is very bad, okay? He don't neither study. He do so many of nonsense in the class, okay? The teacher always used to scold that student. So what the other student used to do? they don't used to talk to that student, okay? They don't like to become the friend of that student. What is this called? This is called racism. What is this called? This is called racism. And racism is a part of a discrimination. So what you are doing over there? Discrimination. What you are doing over there? Discrimination. Okay. A person race is a classification based mainly on what you look like. Your skin color, white or black, for example. Now, it comes to other color also. Okay. Now, every student in the class is too much fair. Okay. Good. Whitish also. Good. But there is one particular student who is very black in color, like the South Africans. So over there, what the students used to do? They used to make fun of that student, okay? They used to discriminate that person. Oh my God, that student is too black in color, okay? See the color of the skin or the color of that student, okay? So what do you do over there? You do the racism. And racism is a sort of a discrimination. And discrimination is unlawful activity. Racism is a unlawful activity, okay? It means you are not supposed to do that racism in the class. You're not supposed to do the discrimination in the class, okay? Usually racism happens in the schools, in the grocery stores, restaurants and so on. You know what? In the previous days when the India was not independent, at that time in the South America, in the America over there, it has been written that specially for the black people, the Africans, okay, they were not being able or not being allowed to enter any restaurants. Even in South Africa, the Indians were not allowed over there. Why? So it was sort of the racism over there, okay? That was sort of a discrimination over there. So, in schools, jobs, grocery store, restaurants, and there are so many several places where racism used to imply. Now, next point is sexism. Sexism over here, it means that it is based on your gender or your sex. Okay? That means sex or gender discrimination. Another more common types of discrimination is sexism. Sexism is when people are discriminated against because of their gender. Okay? Male and a female. See, in our society, usually there are so many discrimination we used to see in day-to-day our life also. A discrimination between male and a female. Male people can do this, female peoples are not allowed to do this. Female people can do this, but the male people cannot do this activity. Now see, it is usually seen with the females and the male people only, okay? Boys are allowed to do move in the night, they can easily move in the night, okay? They can travel also. So many things they can do all alone. But the females are not allowed to do so. Why? So this is called sort of discrimination. Okay? This can come in a form of clothes. Females are expected to wear the types of activities females should enjoy. Okay? Now see, the girls are wearing skirts and frocks and so many good accessories. Okay? With earrings, the jewelry and everything. Do the male people are wearing those? No, they are not wearing those. They are not supposed to be wear. If any person is wearing, the people used to discriminate that male person. See, that male person is wearing jewelry, okay? Because the male people usually don't wear jewelry. Okay, now see, female people, if she wants to make a robot, instead of sewing a shirt, okay, stitching a shirt, now that is said to be, she wants to enjoy that person thing, but she's not been allowed to do so. She has been told, no, do the household work, limited to the household work only, okay? You're not been allowed to move forward. Now, same like here, if the maids wants to do, want to cook or they want to sew the shirt or stitch the shirt in comparison to the making a robot, that is also not been accepted by the society. They have been told, no, you are the male person, so you should move out. You should do some extra work, okay? You should do some creative work. Creative work in your job sector or any other field instead of doing the cooking or stitching any shirt. So this is called sexism. This is called a gender or sex discrimination. What is called gender or sex discrimination? Where we are making male and a female discriminated or different from each other in different aspects of life. Now, comes to the third type of discrimination, that is said to be the religious discrimination. What is the third type? Religious discrimination. Now, religious discrimination, it's been an issue all over the world since a very long duration of time. From the past centuries, we are facing this sort of discrimination in our society. Not only in India, but throughout the whole world, we are facing this problem, okay? Now, religious discrimination is exactly that treating someone differently or badly because of their religion, okay? For example, you have seen over here in India. In India, when usually we are having the Hindu-Muslim fights over there, what has been done? They have been, both the religions are being discriminated from each other, okay? They are not being civilized as or meant as one. They are being individually discriminated from each other. Now here, the Hindu people don't allow the Muslim community to join or mix up with them in their any of the traditions or the cultures. Same like here, the Muslims also don't enjoy or don't like to get the Hindus to be indulge with them. Now, so what does it mean? This is called religious discrimination. Oh my God, that's a Muslim, so we are going to stay apart because he is not from our religion or our culture. Now, you know what? In America, recently a very aggressive scene over there, we have seen that the people have just made the mosques burn, okay? Because they wanted that the Christianity religion should be spread more and more in comparison to the other aspects of other religions, because they were against the Muslim community, the reason because of the spreading out of the terrorism done by the Muslim community. But actually, students, you know, terrorism is not done by the Muslim community, to be very clearly and frankly telling you all. Terrorism is a sort of an activity which is a psychological activity in which is making another person aggressive in form in the nature, not because of the religion, okay? This is a very short, very bad scenario that the people are considering, okay, he is a Muslim, so he might be indulged in the terrorism work. No, that is a very wrong aspect. Terrorists can be of any of the religion. Terrorism doesn't impact or doesn't individualize with any particular religion. He or she can be a Hindu also. He or she can be a Christian also. Okay, that doesn't mean that terrorism is related to the Muslim community only. Okay, now see. Now one, I want to ask a question that, do you think that one should be get afraid in practicing of their religion? I don't think so, Hope. Because it's very a wrong thing that you should be get afraid of practicing your own religion inside your own country where you are living. So over there, this is called religious discrimination, where you are making another person not, and I can say that stopping or forbidding that person to enjoy their religion on their own wish, on their own aspects. Now comes to the racial or ethnic discrimination. Racial or ethnic discrimination is basically depending on the person's ethnicity or race. Ethnicity means belonging to the groups of the people according to the common racial, national, tribal, religious, linguistic. Linguistic means your mother tongue, okay? And other cultural origin or background. I am a Hindu. But I am belonging from a special type of category of the Hindus, okay? That is called the Kai. Now, over there, we cannot discriminate those people from other of the Hindu region. The Brahmins are there, okay, and I am the Kai, so I should be discriminated from the Brahmins. No, it cannot be. It's not true and it's not good, okay? That is called racial or ethnical discrimination. Understood with the racial and ethnic discrimination? Where means you are making a discrimination on the basis of the national, tribal, religious, linguistic or the cultural origin or background. Now let's discuss about what do you mean by disability discrimination. Discrimination based on the fact of that person has a disability. Now what the word term disability refers to? A disability is a long-lasting impairment that limits a major life activity, can include mental or physical. Now imagine, there is a one person in your locality, in your society, who is not normal as you are, okay? Who is used to behave in a very different manner, okay? Having the face not so much as good as you are having. Good means over here, some aspects of the physical or the facial structure is fine. Like that we are having the mouth also, we are having the twisted one, okay? They are not able to talk properly like this, they used to speak, okay? The hands over there are in a different forms, okay? Hands are like this, but when they used to speak something or used to walk or something like that, they have some disability. They are not able to walk properly. Okay, that is said to be the physical, your physical disability. Your hand is not working, okay? Your leg is not working, fine? You are totally on the bed, your body is not working. You are able to see, you are able to talk, you are able to do everything. But that is said to be the physical disability. Mental disability over there means the person is not able to perform well, okay? Perform well means work well as you are walking. They used to behave in a very different manner, okay? Either they used to laugh too much or they used to shout too much, okay? Some people who are have the disability that they used to just talk so much that they are not being aware that on what topic they are speaking, but they are interested in talking and talking, okay? Now, many people are in the mental disability. They used to, shout, scream, okay, very loudly. Sometimes they used to hurt other people also. That is said to be the mental disability. Have you seen the mental asylums? Over there, these sort of people are being sent for the proper treatment. Now, to accommodate disabled employees, employers may have to restructure jobs, alter equipment, modify workstations. Now see, for removing these sort of discrimination from a society, the disability discrimination, for what the people used to do, especially on the workplace where you're doing the job, over there, these people can be just improve the condition. For example, I'm giving you, there is one office, okay? Over there are several people working at one time. Now, among them, there are two people who are coming on the wheelchair because they are not able to walk properly, okay? They are not able to because their legs are not working, so they are coming on the wheelchair. Now, there are the stairs to go or enter the office. Now, over there, how they are able to go? Because they are on the wheelchair, they are not supposed to go over there. So, what the office people can do, what the management can do, they can make a properly clean up stairs, okay, the sliding slopes by which they can go properly and they can come down also, okay. They can change their workstations also, okay, as per their flexibility, as per their neediness, okay, by which they can perform well. That is said to be a good employment, okay, a good workstation where they can work and where you can make the discrimination get aparted or discrimination to be removed from your office. Now, let's discuss about what is prejudice. Now, prejudice is an effective feeling towards a person based on the perceived group membership. Now, what does it mean? We used to make an intuition or imagination about any person without having in contact with them, okay? For example, there are two people talking to each other regarding A, B and C. There are the three people. A and B are talking about C person, that, oh my god, the C person is very bad, he has done this, he has done that, so many rubbish talks he had made about C. Now, B, as being the friend of A, what B has done, B had made it in a mind that C is really a very bad person. So what the intuition he had made, the prejudice he had made, that C is not a good human being, he is a very bad person. Now, instead of contacting to C, instead of making any judgment about or interacting with C, he made the judgment on the behavior aspect of C. Okay, now this is called prejudice. This is called prejudice, and prejudice is actually it comes on the form of discrimination also. Okay, it is when the discrimination is being done, obviously the prejudice always occurs over there, because we used to imagine prior. Okay, for example, now I'll see, when you were small, still at the time when you are in this age, over there, so many things the parents are used to tell you, that if you are going, don't take anything from that person because he's from the scheduled caste or the scheduled tribes, okay? Don't talk to the sweepers too much, okay? Don't talk to the maids too much, okay? They are not from our class or from our level, okay? So what does it mean? It is making your mind to be a prejudice form. It's making your mind to be, make a discrimination inside the society, because as per your teachings which has been given to you, that is called prejudice. Now understood with the meaning of prejudice? Over there, where you are making your imagination or conception about any person or a group or a community without interacting or without having a deep knowledge about the same. Now, Gordon Allport defined prejudice as feeling favorable or unfavorable toward a person or thing prior to or not based on actual experience. It means you are not being interacted with that, or you have not gone through the same situation, but you are being told to analyze or judge the person on the basis of your assumption, on the basis of your feeling, whatever the things you have heard from other group or other people. Now, some of the most well-known types of prejudice includes racism, sexism, ages, classes, nationalism and religious prejudice. Now over here, have you heard and just have you looked that these all are the factors or the types that we had discussed with the discrimination. It means now that prejudice and discrimination are equal to each other. Okay, they are the part of each other. They are not being separated from each other. But only the thing is that discrimination, actually prejudice is a type of a behavior that we do on the basis of discrimination, and all these types come and include with the types of the discrimination only. When we think that we have to do discrimination on the basis of ageism or racism or the sexism or the gender discrimination or any disability discrimination, where then we have to have the behavior of the prejudice. Okay, so have you now understood that don't get confused with the two terms, prejudice and discrimination. They both are interrelated to each other. What are interrelated to each other? Prejudice and discrimination. Okay, now once again I repeat, what are the two things that are being interrelated to each other? Prejudice and discrimination. Okay, so never get confused with this, that prejudice is different from the discrimination or discrimination is different from the prejudice. The types of the prejudice and the types of the discrimination are same. Okay, now come and let's discuss about the causes of prejudice. Okay, the person's upbringings may cause them to become prejudiced. If parents had prejudice of their own, there is a chance that these opinions will be passed on to the next generation. One bad experience with a person from a particular group can cause a person to think of all from that group in the same way. Now what does it mean? It means, now I'll take an example. There is a person or there is any relative who has done really very bad with your parents or with your family members. Okay? You are a child and you don't know about it, each and everything. But now your parents, as being becoming an elder now, okay, grown up child now, your parents have told you, sir, please stay apart from that relative because he or she is not good for our family members. Now, over there, what actually you did? You did and you made that whatever your parents have told you, that we should not go and talk to that person, we should not go and meet that person, okay, as we are meeting other relatives. So that is said to be the prejudice behavior we are performing, and we follow what the parents are being telling or guiding us to do. So this is actually the cause of prejudice, that usually it happens in a particular personal life, that whatever the elders used to say to us and whatever they have assumptions earlier, they used to imply that so same assumptions and same behavior and expect from their children too to follow the same thing. That are said to be, these are actually said to be the causes of the prejudices. Now, it means the behavior, previous behavior, and which is we are passing to generation to generation. Now, comes to the effects of the prejudice. What actually the impact of this prejudice have? Prejudice makes a victim feel less than fully human. When people are undervalued by others, their self-esteem suffers, okay? And they stop trying to improve themselves. Prejudice can often lead for bullying and other forms of discrimination. Now, what does it mean? It means that, see, when you are making different or when we are discriminated any particular person from the group, we are not talking to that person. We are, as we are laughing, we are talking, we are roaming about here and there, okay? So much gossips we are doing with other relatives, but with that particular relative, no one is talking. So just imagine that how that person is going to feel. Take yourself, your own example. If in the class I am coming to teach you and you are the only one particular student whom I am not concentrating at all, whom I am not able talking to you and asking you the questions, okay, not telling you to read the chapters or any other thing. Because this is my mentality, because as we just imagine that I have taken that you are a very weak student, you cannot do anything for me for the studies, okay, you are not, can be good in studies at all. So over there, what does it mean? Over there it means that I am making then discrimination over there, okay. Over there it means that you are, according to me, I am having a prejudiced behavior, and the same behavior I am playing with other students also, that I am telling them not to talk to that particular student because he or she is not good. That is said to be the effects of prejudice. Over there, what actually you are going to feel? You are going to feel very bad inside from your, okay, you are seeing that I am a very different from others, okay, do I am not a human being over there? It means so, because the ma'am is not behaving with me only in the class properly. She's laughing, she's talking to everyone, but she's not talking to me. Why so? Do I am so much bad? Okay, over there the self-esteem suffers, okay? Over there the person used to think that what actually I should do to improve up myself, okay? And they make themselves to be separated from others. They are being discriminated from others and they feel inferiority complex from inside of their heart, which used to affect their performance also. They used to feel very negative in mind, okay? Very negativity in the mind occurs over there, and which is very bad for the society. So students, discrimination is very bad for the society, okay? Where you should not do the discrimination, because discrimination leads to the psychological X factors also, psychological bad impacts also, okay, where the people used to, sometimes they used, you know, so they used to hurt themselves, okay, they feel so much depressed, they get in the, become the patients of depression also, because why we are the people, do we are not the human beings, why we all are being discriminated from the society like this, okay, so these are the causes of the prejudice and these are the effects of the prejudice. Now, let's discuss what are the three components of the prejudice. The prejudiced person may not act on their attitude. Therefore, someone can be prejudiced towards a certain group but not discriminate against them. Also, prejudice includes all three components of an attitude: affective, behavior, and cognitive. Now, cognitive over here means where you are in trying to interrelate the two things with each other, okay? You are merging the things with each other. You want that the things should be as per your own expectation. What I am wishing the same person should imply or should impose that thing, whereas the discrimination just involves behavior. Now see, prejudices involve three things: affective, behavior, and cognitive, okay? But discrimination only about your behavior. So this is a major difference between the prejudice and your discrimination. Discrimination is only related to the behavior aspect, but prejudice because it's coming for your psychological factor through your mind, whatever you are thinking from inside your mind. So obviously what you are thinking, your attitude becomes like that, your behavior becomes like that. Even sometimes if I want your parents wants to, they don't talk to any relative, obviously they are imposing that thing on you also, that you should also don't talk to that person because we are not talking. Why we are not talking? Because that person is not good for our family. So over there, these are the things that we use to decide, or these are the three components that are coming for the prejudice, okay? And rest other things are been concluding or coming in the part of the, only the behavior coming in the part of discrimination. And what are the three parts which are coming in the components of prejudice? Affective, behavioral and cognitive, okay? So don't forget all these things, clear? Now, what is the difference between bias and prejudice? Now, understand with the difference between bias and prejudice. Prejudice and bias are usually considered to be closely related to each other. Prejudice is a prejudgment, okay, or forming an opinion before becoming aware of relevant fact of a case. Now, what does it mean? That bias is actually coming after that we have already experienced that thing, okay? So imagine I'm taking, as I told you, for the parents. Parents had already experienced any bad effect or any bad scenario with any particular relative. So over there, that is said to be the bias. They have already experienced one, okay? But you are not experienced one over there. So what you are doing? You are making the prejudice, okay? Over there, you are accepting that same behavior what your parents are doing with that particular relative. So over here, prejudice is a prejudgment, okay? As per your whatever you have listened, whatever you have been taught, as per that, you have made a prejudgment, okay? Now, previous in the olden days, it was being said that scheduled caste, scheduled tribes on the basis of the casteism was being done. The gender, the male and the female were being done. We were having the prejudgment, okay? Still now, the prejudgment is being done, the prejudice is being done in the society. There are several things that the male people can do, females cannot do. And over there, it is said that females are not allowed to do such type of rituals because these sort of rituals are being done only by the male people. So this is the prejudgment that we made. Why females cannot do like that? Why I cannot talk to that person, to that my relative? Maybe he or she might be good with me. There might be so many other conditions at that duration when he or she had reacted bad or opposite to your parents, okay? Opposite behavior, had an opposite behavior towards your parents. But over here, with us, he or she can be good with me. Now, this is the prejudice, okay? Bias is done for the post-judgment, okay? When you have got experience and after that, you are making an exception and you are changing your behavior, your attitude and all, that is called bias. Prejudice is said to be an sort of a judgment which is not done earlier, okay? Which is done, or the prejudgment, before having any experience regarding the same. So, in this presentation, in this part one, what we discussed about, we discussed what do you mean by discrimination, okay? We discussed what are the types of discrimination we have. So, how many types of discrimination we have? We learned about? We learned about the five types of discrimination. And what were those? Age or gender discrimination, sexism, you can count the age, gender and the sex discrimination. Next one is, that is said to be the racial or ethical discrimination, age discrimination, disability discrimination, okay, and the religious discrimination. So how many types of discrimination we heard about now? The gender or sex discrimination, racial or ethnic discrimination, disability discrimination and age discrimination, and including the last one is said to be the religious discrimination. Now understood about the types of the discrimination we have learned? Okay. Now prejudice and the discrimination are interrelated to each other. Okay. Prejudice is a prejudgment, what we do or what we make or what we think about any particular criteria or the group of people or individual people. Got it? But discrimination is based on only on the behavior. Okay. The components, okay, but the prejudice had three components, and what were those? They were your attitude. Okay, what second one? Your behavior, and the third one was the cognitive. Got it, everyone? Now, what is the difference between bias and the prejudice? Bias and the prejudice over here means where your prejudice is a prejudgment and bias is a post-judgment as per your experience. Okay, so learn it all thoroughly. The difference between the similarities between the discrimination and the prejudice. Okay, read the chapter properly. Thank you for watching me this video. Have a great day ahead.